Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see the topic of overlap add method for linear FIR filtering a long sequence. Already I explained how to perform the overlap save method for linear FIR filtering a long sequence in my earlier video. Here we are going to see the overlap add method for filtering of long data sequence. We will discuss this overlap add method with the help of simple example. In this method, we have to consider the length of the input sequence LS and the length of impulse response is M. Now, the input sequence is divided into blocks of data having length L and M minus 1 zeros are added to it make the data size of L plus M minus 1. That is, we are going to divide this input sequence X of N into non-overlapping blocks XM of N of length L. That is, we are going to divide the input sequence by blocks XM of N. So here we are going to divide that input sequence by M number of blocks, each block having the length of N, that N value equal to L plus M minus 1. Here L is stands for size of the new data points and M length of H of N, and N is nothing but size of blocks of data. Next step, we are going to do zero padding on H of N to make the length of N. That is, N value is given as L plus M minus 1. Then, next we have to take N point DFT on H of N and we can get H of K. Here, K varies from 0 to N minus 1 because which is N point DFT. That's why K varies from 0 to N minus 1. For each block M, we have to take 0 pad XM of N to be the length N is equal to L plus M minus 1. That means we are going to do 0 padding in each block's data and it will make the length as N. That N value is equal to L plus M minus 1. After that, we have to take endpoint DFT of input sequence of the block XM of N to give XM of K. So, here also K varies from 0 to N minus 1. Now, we are having two DFTs. One is H of K and another one is XM of K. Now, we are going to multiply these two DFTs. We are getting YM of K. So, YM of K is equal to XM of K multiply with H of K, where K varies from 0 to N minus 1. So, after getting of YM of K, then we are going to take N point IDFT of YM of K, we can have the value of YM of N. So, here N varies from 0 to N minus 1. So, in this way, we can find out that output sequence of each block from the H of K and XM of K. So, now we are having each block output sequence YM of N. So, from that YM of N, we are going to form the Y of N. So, how we are going to form the Y of N is here. So, form Y of N by overlapping the last M minus N samples of YM of N with the rest of M minus 1 samples of Y M plus 1 of N and adding the result. That means each block data is terminated with M minus 1 zeros. The last M minus 1 points from each output block must be overlapped and added to the first M minus 1 samples of the succeeding block. So we have to call it as overlap add method. That means emanation points from each output block must be overlapped and added to the first emanation samples or points of the succeeding block. So that's why we are call it as overlap add method. Now we are going to see the simple example which is already taken for the previous method, that is overlap save method. So we are going to compare the result with the previous method, that is overlap method. That's why we are taking the same problem. We are going to solve this problem by overlap add method. So the given question is, that is input sequence x of n is 3 minus 1 0 1 3 2 0 1 2. That means input sequence having the length is 9, that is LS is equal to 9, and the impulse response length is 3 because h of n is equal to 1 1 1, that is capital M is equal to 3 here, that is impulse response length is 3 and input sequence length is 9. So now we are going to divide this input sequence by m number of blocks. So here take L is equal to 3, that means we are going to take L, that is which having the criteria of L is greater than or equal to m. That's why here m is 3, that's why we have to take L is equal to 3. That means you are going to divide that input sequence by 3 3 pairs. 3 minus 1 0 is first pair, 1 3 2 second pair, 0 1 2 that is the third pair. So in the first block input sequence, x1 of n is equal to what is that first pair, that is 3 minus 1 0. So you have to take that first pair 3 minus 1 0, that is it having the length of L. After that it is followed by m minus 1 zeros we are going to add it here, that is m minus 1. That means each block having the length of L plus m minus 1. Already we are having the length of L, so we have to add m minus 1 zeros here. So finally we are getting L plus m minus 1 datas. So 3 minus 1 0, after that we have to add 2 zeros because m is equal to 3 here. So then we can go for the next block data sequence. X2 of n is equal to the next pair, we are going to take it as 1 3 2, then you are writing here, after that you have to padding 2 zeros because of m minus 1 zeros we have to add here. So the next data sequence is 1 3 2 0 0. The same way we can go for the third block data, that is x3 of n is equal to what is the third pair, 0 1 2. So you have to take it as 0 1 2 and we have to add m minus 1 zeros here. So all the three blocks which having the length of L plus M minus 1. The same way we are going to make the length H of N also L plus M minus 1. That means already we have the length M is equal to 3, that is 1 1 1. So we have to add here L minus 1 zeros. So L minus 1, L is also 3. So L minus 1 is 2 zeros we have to add here. That means the H of N is also having the length of 5. That's why we have to add L minus 1 0 here. So 1 1 1 0 0, that is equal to H of N is here. So after making these steps, we are going to perform the circular convolution of each input of the blocks, that is XM of N and H of N. That is we are going to perform the circular convolution on xm of n with h of n. Already explained how to perform the circular convolution in my earlier videos. Please check that videos. Here I am showing the results directly. So what is the first block output sequence, that is yn of n is equal to x1 of n n point circular convolution with h of n, that is equal to what is my result, that is you are going to do that circular convolution, that is endpoint circular convolution between that x1 of n and h of n. So that brings that gives the answer is 3 2 2 minus 1 0 and so on. We can go for that next next block output, that is y2 of n is equal to, we make the circular convolution, n point circular convolution between that x2 of n and h of n. We are getting 1, 4, 6, 5 and 2 and so on. We can go for the third block also. So what is the output of the third block? Y3 of n is equal to x3 of n is convolution, that is n point circular convolution with h of n, that is also is given as 0, 1, 3, 3 and 2. Now we are having each output sequence of the blocks as y1 of n, y2 of n and y3 of n. Now we are going to form the y of n, that is output from the yn of n and y2 of n and y3 of n. How we are going to make it y of n here? Okay, so in the first block we have to take three samples as it is, 3, 2, 2. That is, we have to take that L points as it is. Then we can have that M minus 1 points is here. The next data, next block data is M minus 1, first M minus 1 points is here. So now you have to overlap and add it, these two sequence. That means minus 1 added with 1 and 0 added with 4. Then we get the result as 0 and 4. That is minus 1 added with plus 1, we are getting 0. Then 0 added with 4, we are getting 4. Then the next is 6, 6. As it is, we can take it in the y of n. After that, we are having m minus 1 points is here. So the next block, m minus 1 points is here. You have to add with that m minus 1 points. 5 and 0 added, you are getting 5. And 2 and 1 added, you are getting 3. So the remaining 3, this 3 is as it is, it comes. The next, that is 3 and 2, there is no block furtherly. That's why we have to take that 3 and 2 as it is. So final answer, that is y of n is equal to 3, 2, 2, 0, 4, 6, 5, 3, 3, 3, 2. So which is equal to whatever we are getting in the overlap save method. So both are equal answer we are getting. So we are coming for we are coming to the conclusion part. So therefore, for the long duration sequences, the response of LTA or LSI system, that is LTA stands for linear time invariant, which is also called as LSI, linear shift invariant system, can be found by using block convolution known as fast convolution, using segmentation algorithms, that is segmentation methods, overlap add and overlap save methods. So this, which is faster than the methods using DFT and IDFT. Thank you.